Hi, it's Miss Maddie. So today in our lesson, we are going to be making this little caterpillar on a mushroom house. And it's gonna turn out something like this. So you're gonna need a paper, pen, or pencil, and eraser. And then I use watercolor. So if you want, you can use watercolor and water and a brush. But if you want, you can also use colored pencil or oil pastel or maybe some paint. It's up to you. And your colors can be different as well. They don't have to be exactly the same as mine. But if you want, you can follow me. All right, let's get started. Okay, so we're gonna start with this mushroom cap right here. So we're gonna draw this shape. It's like a half circle. And then it gets wider at the bottom. And then these edges here are round. So we're gonna go in like this, and then it goes up. And connects to the other side where the other edge is round. Then this mushroom has three circles, but they're not the full circle, only half the circle. So we're gonna start with one here, draw half a circle, and one up here, and one at the bottom. And then we're gonna sketch really lightly from right here to right here, two dots. We're going to draw all the way across very lightly. We're doing it lightly because then we're going to draw this inside part. So then we're going to go and do a dot here and a dot on this side. And that's these two parts right here. So from those two dots, it goes down and then it goes out. Other side, down, and out. So then I'm going to make these lines darker. Make it a little smaller there. And darker. And then this line that we drew here, we're going to draw darker lines right here. And then once you get to that part, stop. Then come over here and draw from here to here, darker, but we stop. We don't go over this part. So at this part, you can get an eraser and just erase that part. So now this part is in front of this part. I'm gonna erase this little line here. And then on the inside here, we can draw these little lines. Those are the gills of a mushroom. Okay. Now right here, we're gonna draw a circle for the window. Circle, and then we'll do a line going inside like that, and across like the letter T. And that's the window. And then we're going to draw some grass right here. And it goes all the way across, and that's our ground. grass in front of the house too. Some little spikes. Maybe some down here as well. And then we'll draw our door. So the door kind of looks like a rainbow. It's an arch like that. We'll draw a doorknob. Just a little circle. And then I've drawn my door, like a little gate almost. So a line across, the line's going down. And then the bottom of the door. And I did a little welcome mat. Yours can be square or a different shape. And now we're gonna do some flowers down in our grass. So to start with a circle and then do the flower petals. I have 5 flower petals. Almost done. Now we've got this little pipe going up like the chimney. So it goes up to the right and then up. So we'll start here, up to the right and up. Then we'll do the same line here, up to the right and up. Then we'll draw a line across and we'll make a little triangle. That's the top of the chimney. And then we're gonna draw stripes, so it looks like a little pipe. And then the most important part, well, we're gonna draw our caterpillar. So, or maybe he is a worm. From the middle of our mushroom, draw a little dot right there. From there, we're gonna go up, make a round head and a wiggly body. So it goes up and down, and he has a little tail coming out. And it comes back into the mushroom right here. And then we can kind of see this part of him is curving. So we're gonna draw a little half circle right there. And we're gonna give him stripes. Stop right there. And there's your little wormy. And we're gonna give him a little face. And you can make his face look however you want. 2 eyes. And a nose. Some eyebrows maybe. And a smile. Ta-da! Okay, now you can color it however you want. I'm gonna color it with watercolor. So if you have watercolor at home, you can use watercolor. If not, you can use colored pencils or markers or oil pastels or chalk or paint, whatever you want. I'm gonna use watercolor. My watercolor here. Some water. And I'm gonna start. You can paint it whatever color you want. I'm gonna do how I want. Okay. So I'm making my mushroom cap a nice bright red. I'm going to be very careful not to go outside of the lines that I drew, because I drew them for a reason. going around the lines first so I can get that done quicker. And then once I get to the inside, I can go a little crazy. I can go like, ooh. But for when I'm doing the lines like this, I want to go slow. You want to make sure you have enough paint on your brush. Then maybe on one side, I want to make it a little bit darker. Maybe it has some shading on it. So I can get a darker red, mix it with my lighter red. Do that. And if you put some water and you look closely, you'll notice that it starts spreading. Now I'm gonna move to my grass. I'm gonna mix two different colors of green. Remember, I'm going slow where the lines are. Maybe I need to switch my brush to a smaller one. This one's smaller. gonna switch to a bigger brush. Going in straight lines like this, because then you're going to see all the lines. So I'm making little circles. So it makes a nice texture to it. See like this when it dries. Now I'm going to do my background. I'm going to make it a blue color. And I want to be careful that I don't get too close to something I already painted, because if it's still wet, they'll bleed together and make a different color, which I don't want. So I'm leaving a little space right there. This part's dry, so I can go next to it. Thank you. easier. It's made of wood. This little chimney, I'm gonna do like a gray color. Kind of like its middle. I think this gray is too dark, so I'm gonna be adding more water to it. I put some here, and I'm just gonna add more water to it so it gets a little bit lighter. You can barely see it right there, but. Like to start out, you can put the color down and then add more to it later so it gets darker. So this looks a little bit too light. So then I'll go back, add a little bit more color. Not too much. I'll layer more. Extra. Now these parts I want to do, I'm not going to leave them white, but I'm going to make them like a creamy color. So I'm going to get this brown, mix maybe a little yellow in it. Here. The more water I add, the lighter it will be. So I'm gonna just add water. Inside parts, the gills, I'm going to make them darker, but it's the same color. Okay. I'm going to make my doorknob
yellow.
Yellow on my brush. I'm gonna make my caterpillar stripes yellow and green. And I'm gonna give him pink cheeks.
Ours the same color.
And that's it. Thanks for painting with me today. Don't forget to make cool, weird decisions when you're making your artwork. And as always, check out our website and our Instagram. Goodbye.